We have now assembled ground units ready to download all data from the Krakow Corporation headquarters. Slater and Ricardo will provide air support for the ground units in case things get out of hand. However, we don't expect resistance, as we destroyed their military hardware very effectively. Once the data drives have been retrieved, they'll be loaded onto your gunship for delivery to G-Police HQ. Please be aware that corporation officials may attempt to escape. If this happens, they should be captured without inflicting harm.
Control to Alpha Wing. Provide air cover for the data retrieval unit. Over.
Control to Alpha Wing. Escort Ground Team Epsilon. Over.
Ground Team Epsilon reporting. We're on our way. Over. Ground Team Epsilon Alpha Wing. We are under attack.
Slater.
Job.
Control to Alpha Wing. You have more hostiles incoming. Over. Control to Alpha Wing. Cover G police units. Over.
Epsilon to Alpha Wing, we're in position. Download has begun. Maintain covering fire. Over. Ground team Epsilon to Alpha Wing, download is 25% complete. Over. Team Epsilon to Alpha Wing, download is 50% complete. Please maintain covering fire. Over. Ground Team Epsilon to Alpha Wing, download is 75% complete. Over.
Krakow officials are escaping. Disable them.
Ground Team Epsilon to Alpha Wing. Download complete. Over. Nanosoft? What are they doing here? We have multiple Nanosoft airborne incoming. Good work, Slayer.
Clear the area of all Nanosoft units. Good work, Slayer. Control to Alpha Leader. Mission status accomplished. Over.
It is not known why Nanosoft attacked G-Police units, or why they were trying to destroy the Krakow HQ. We have several analyst teams studying the retrieved data right now. It seems likely that the information may well contain a few answers. You will be notified of further developments. For the moment, Please be aware that the corporate conflict no longer appears to be over.
Now, NanoSoft had joined the fun. They'd been lying to us all the time, and it looked like Horton had bought it all. He couldn't be that dumb. All my suspicions about the virus and the Cortex chips came flooding back as I stormed into his office and accused him of selling us out. Horton was a cool one, all right. Didn't even blink an eyelid. Turned out, he'd always suspected NanoSoft but couldn't gain enough evidence. Being aware of the traitor, Horton had hidden his suspicions to keep NanoSoft off his back while he methodically took Krakow to pieces. Hell, you had to admire the guy. He'd even tried to cover our backs on that last mission. A recon patrol under Ricardo had been secretly dispatched to warn against any NanoSoft first strike. It was just bad luck that the patrol got jumped. Ricardo had suffered a downed comlink just before his wingman got flamed. By the time he got back with the news that NanoSoft were attacking, it was too late. The traitor was still loose, but at least the data dump from Krakow's HQ promised to be interesting. With Krakow out of the way, we could now put the heat on NanoSoft. Horton planned to fill us all in at the next briefing. I went to check on Ricardo to see if he was okay.